So, Snake Eyes, what are you gonna do 1 week after your last video?
She got her hands all on her knees and then her bows on her thigh. She like to twerk and that's for certain cause I can see how she vibe. She got me hype, I wanna bite it right now, yeah, yeah. Say, ah, yeah, 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 yeah. You can show the shell, make that thing clear. Dudes in the club, spinning dudes when it's bad. Thinking real fine, standing 5'9". High heels on, right on time. Oh man, look at Shawty, she making that thing.
Pack Crackers and Crack Packers, what's up? It's your boy Snake Eyes 2314 once again coming to you live from the Card Cave. That is right. It is Friday. It's a great day. TGIF, one drink, everyone knows the rule. Get those mules popping. We don't let that fun ever get stopping. Whatever that means. All right. You see it on the board. We got that good housekeeping to get to. And we also got that fresh pack to crack. So, let's get it. We are well in to March Madness. I hope your brackets aren't as busted on as Coach A at a Skeens concert, at a little cosplay fucking doodad, whatever they call them. All right, here we go. First, one take, boom, everyone knows their rules. Here, one take, everyone knows the rules. Let's take another drink ski. Let's put this back on the board. Let's walk out of frame. Hold on. All right, and we're back. Here we are. Let's do it. First note on the board, one drink. Say it with me. Everyone knows the rules. NFL free agency is going. Full disclosure, I'm not sure when the fuck it ends, but we know what's going on because we're getting those ESPN alerts constantly. This team that, that team this team that. For whatever reason, Billy Whitwiz, Philadelphia Cream Cheese, Billy Cheesesteak, Allentown Ambassador, and the architect of Altoona. I don't know why in the flying fuck y'all in Pittsburgh, gross, decided to sign Juju Smith-Schuster again, but you did. You're tied down. That boy cannot ball. But, as you know, your boy Snake Eyes 2314 is an exclusive Cincinnati Bengals fan, as sad as that might be. This next year is our year. Let's go, baby. Joe Burrow coming back, about to fuck shit up. But the Bengals didn't do a goddamn thing. Free agency, Mike Brown, sorry son of a bitch, I'm saving up my pennies, I'm going to come by that team, and I'm going to show you how to run a championship franchise. Dig it. Next. Oh, this one's too hot to touch. Don't want to get anywhere near that. All I'll say is Deshaun Watson, you nasty son of a bitch. What the are you doing, bud? You know, hey, everyone can get a little massage, but when you're asking them to tickle your tenders, pal, that's where it goes too far. My guess is you're fucked. If anyone knows, hey, Coach A, if anyone knows the telephone number to a good quarterback, better hit them Texans because they're going to need one. Deshaun, you ain't playing shit, pal. All right, next we have, and this one's going to come around full circle, daddy, when we get to Coach A's corner. That's right, we're bringing it back this week. But we're talking about former Browns player Kellen Winslow Jr. Might as well warm up a bed and grab him a sheet, pal, because Deshaun Watson's going to be bunking with you soon. 14 years for what you did. Dude, you ran Cleveland. All you had to do was walk outside and say, hey, I play for the Browns, and those nasty fire crotch, river-smelling hoes up there are going to come fucking wafting all over your dirty nuts. You know what I mean? Speaking of dirty nuts, check this out. Manscaped has got you covered. Your boy Snake Eyes 2314 has partnered with Manscaped. So we're going to go ahead and show you this beautiful, there it is, set you can get. Coach A, I know you were on Facebook talking about washing your balls for whatever reason. Let me hook you up with this ball deodorizer because we know you got the stinkiest nuts in the game. And also, if you want to get those silky smooth snake eggs like your boy Snake Eyes 2314, go ahead and get that lawnmower 3.0. We've got the ceramic blade so you don't nick your sack. If you want to get a little, look, if we can cut Yep, that's right, those. If we can cut those tennis balls all nice and smooth like, you know we can take care of those snake eggs, baby. We got the LED light in case you gotta go rumbling and tumbling in the dark. It is waterproof. It is shockproof. It comes with that beautiful stand so you can show it off loud and proud. Remember, use promo code SNAKEEGGS in the promo code box. Save 20% at checkout. Also, your boy has always got your shipping. And hey, ladies, you know, you like the smooth snake eggs. Well, guess what? Some people like that Card Cave trimmed a little bit. So, you know, go ahead and take care of your own good housekeeping. It's not just for dudes. It's called Manscaped. But hey, use good weed whack too. All right, next. Oh, and by the way, link down in the description. Gotcha. All right. Speaking of brackets busted and nuts tusted, here we go. Gonzaga, our number one pick on the Snake Eyes bracket. Full disclosure, I picked up the teams for my team at work. We're about to win that free lunch. So any of you watching, and I know you all do, your boy Snake Eyes 2314 right now, go ahead and once again, I'm going to say it, lock it in. Take it to the bank. It's over. It's a wrap. Our bracket guaranteed winner, Gonzaga. Don't let me down. Make sure we are like Ric Flair. My team was about to be that Rolex wearing, limousine riding, jet flying, wheeling and dealing, kiss stealing, son of a gun. Woo! Because we're going to win. All right. Speaking of brackets, speaking of busted, you got teams like Oral Roberts, Colgate, the Dentists College of America out there making toothpaste and making toothbrushes. Also, you got Sister Mary Catherine working for Loyola of Chicago, running the fucking gauntlet out there, coaching like she's back on Eddie. That's right, two Whoopi Goldberg references in one video. Let me see anyone else doing that. You can't show me. Here we go. All right, we already said it, Oral Roberts. You know, put it in the comments where the fuck that school is, and I'll give you a prize. I'll give you a, however, here we go, hold on. Let's take a little breather. Let's go ahead and bring it down for a second. One drink, everyone knows the rules, and now let's bring it back up, because we don't get hyped, we stay hyped. Oral Roberts, if you can tell me in the comments where they are from, I will send you however many cards they get to. Make sense? So they started with 64, you get 64 cards. Then they went to 32, you get 32 cards. So automatically that's 96 cards. Now they're gonna tweet 16. So that's 114 cards. And if they get to the Elite Eight, that's 122 cards. They make it to the Final Four, that's 126 cards. They make it to the Final Two, that's 128 cards. They make it to the final game. They make it to the final game. I will give you, I will send you personally 129 of those cards that we have cracked and we have packed, baby. All right, now, getting to the park that we all love where we crack those packs, pack those cracks. We got Score NFL 1990 cards. I don't have any college basketball cards. Full disclosure, I don't have any basketball cards on me right now. All right, so in honor of the Bengals, in honor of free agency, we're about to pop the top on this motherfucker right here. Let's get it, daddy. Let's go. Here we go. Pop that pack, crack that pack, get those cards, put them in a stack. Pop that pack, get that pack, put them cards in that stack, put them off to the side, give them to your fans. You know what we do? Clap them hands. All right, new song. It's a remix, it's a rap. Let's go. Here we are. Flop, 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 flop. Let's do it. Next, we have, Johnny Come Lately, Johnny Come On Skeens, fucking Hector, playing for the J-E-T-S, Jets, Jets, Jets. Warren, War and Peace, bud. This is your team. Full disclosure, I don't know who he is.
He's Warren in your contacts. Who do you want to send it to?
One take, everyone knows the rules. Surrey, shut the fuck up. All right, here we go. He's a running back. Whoa. One take, everyone knows the rules. One too many drink skis for me. He is our running back, and it's not because he's Blick. He is for the Jets. That wasn't a racist comment. If you guys have ever seen Lethal Weapon 2, that's the reason that fucking Murtaugh, nope, take that back, Riggs, whoever it is, Danny Glover, can't go to South Africa. Watch it before you jump in my comments with that bullshit. Snake Eyes loves everybody, baby. All right, next, celebrating the newest Super Bowl champs, we have Chris. Fucking give me more. Look at that boy, that creamsicle jersey. That ball's just floating in the air, laces out. Ray, laces out. That boy knows how to kick that ball. Next, we're gonna go ahead and give you, holy hell, Mario. I'm gonna go ahead and bring this into you tomorrow because this boy is getting that full stretch. That full stretch. I'm not even gonna try it because I don't wanna pull a fucking muscle. But here we go. Mike Saxon is getting ready for some Dallas Sexton, if you know what I mean. That boy's beans are all tucked, plucked, and ready to go. Holy hell, we are just getting everyone's cards. The mayor of, what's the neighborhood over there, guys? The mayor of Royal Manor. I don't know why I always forget it. Produce Pimp, the Mondo Magpie. Here is quarterback Chris Chandler. I'm guessing he was a placeholder before your boy came and ran Peytonville all over the place. Next, we have Atlanta Falcons, that dirty bird. Mike, gimme the gun Gan. He is a defensive end. Oh, there we go. Don't know much about him. Looks like he's putting the wood. That's what Skeens does to the Niners there. Sorry about that, Gahanna Dan. Next, we have Billy Wit Wiz, Philadelphia Cream Cheese, Billy Cheesesteak, Billy Philly, or Philly Billy, Altoona Ambassador, and the Architect of Allentown. Here is your second team because you're Denver Bronco bound. You're that Ratto boy, that Ratto rider. We have Tyrone Higgins Braxton. Oh, nope. One too many drinks, so let's go ahead and take another one. One drink, everyone knows the rules. Full disclosure, it looks like that's an eagle. Nope, I was right. Just so you guys know, I didn't fuck up. They did. I got him holding a ball, but it's his card. Billy Wit Wiz, that's on you, pal. What do you guys fucking... You eat cheesesteaks in Philly. You eat shit in Pittsburgh. What do you eat in Ratto? Fucking hatch chilies and fucking oyster nuts or Rocky Mountain oyster bull nuts. There you go. All pro Albert Lewis for the Chiefs. Back when the Chiefs weren't shit. That boy's wishing, hoping, and praying he was playing now. But you're not. Fuck off. Next, we've got, oh, Jason. This one's coming to you, pal. Keith Van Horny. That boy is on the field like a predator. Next, we have for the Cardinals, Tony Air Michael Jordan. Getting the ball, making it happen. Look at those stats. Pause it. Let me know. Next, we've got Mervin. I wish I was Bo Jackson, but I'm not that good ever. Fernandez. But he is running the fuck out of those sorry ass Seattle Seahawks. Way before Russell Wilson was there. Oh, we got that hot rookie. We got that hot rookie. We're going to save those hot takes for later. Go ahead and give you that tease. The Giants, Joe Big Toe Morris. Huh? Ask Skeens. I'll tell you what the other big thing about him is. Full disclosure, I don't know, but we got Leo like a motherfucking boss. Lewis, wide receiver, Vikings. Here we go. Fun fact about Leo Lewis. Leo Lewis is the primary full-time and head hedge fund CEO backer for the Mall of America. He had a personal hand in dedicating 16 of the stores to his mother, and other family members. They started these businesses, and those businesses to this day in 2021 are still around. Look it up. Take it to the bank. All right, we got another Denver Bronco. I don't know what the hell's up with all these kickers. You know what? These 90 packs are like baseball. They give me all kickers. All the baseball does is give me fucking pitchers. Either way, they all have mustaches and look like porn stars. Next, Terry McDaniel. I bet Al Davis drafted him because that boy is fast. And we got those rookie cards. One from the Seminoles, Peter Tom Willis. I have never heard of you, so I'm guessing you didn't do shit. Go ahead and look on those milk cartons for him because they're with his career. Fucking L-O-S-T, lost, lost, lost. And if anyone's going to get you H-A-R-D, it's Snake Eyes 2314 and these packs he's cracking and those cracks he's packing. All right, last card. You want it? If you're a Notre Dame nutsack, let me know because I'm going to fucking rip this card up right in front of your face. Notre Dame sucks. Michigan sucks. North Korea sucks. Syria sucks. Iran sucks. And you know those nutsacks up north, those maple syrup dripping, maple tree stroking idiots in Canada can go fuck off too. All right. Once again, these packs have been cracked. I've cracked your pack. One drink. Everyone knows the goddamn rules. Hit the lights. Cue the music. Crack Packers for life. Let's go. Woo! All right, baby. Here we are. High energy. You know we don't get hype. The CPA stays hype. All right. Coach A's corner. You see the sign. You know the rules. Go ahead and say it with me. One drink. Everyone knows the rules. Let's go ahead and grab that playbook and see how our tenders get tickled this week and what we've got to say, and more importantly, what he's got to say. Let's go. All right, Coach A's God damn, it's hard to find good help around here. One take, everyone knows the rules. Coach A's playbook. We still got the motherfucker. It's getting thicker. That's what she said. Here we are. All right. Week, whatever this is, in March Madness. I don't know when you're going to watch it. Technically, shit, you might even watch it. March Madness is over. In that case, drop the winner in there, and maybe they match up with what we're thinking, what's on our brackets. But Coach A's boy, that spicy leather motherfucker, here we are. And he says, I have a natural talent for making a great bracket. Even though I don't watch a lot of college ball. Hopefully this is a winning bracket. Well, motherfucker, no. Ohio State got bounced out by Oral Roberts. They might be the ones who make the fucking Oral-B toothbrush. I don't know. Anyways, Adam says, as someone who has watched Ohio State all year, your bracket is done. Ion rings. I don't know what the fuck that means. If you do, drop it in the comments. But here we go. Oh, shit. Phillip is going to cut a hell of a promo. Please hang in there with me. And I quote, you know they say that all teams are created equal. But you look at us and you look at Oral Roberts and you can see that statement is not true. See, normally, if you go one-on-one with another team, you got a 50-50 chance of winning. But we're a generic... Blah, 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 blah. One take, everyone knows the rules, skis. But we're a genetic freak, and we're not normal. So you got a 25% chance at best to beat us. Then add Arizona State to the mix. Your chances of winning drastic go down. See the final four? You got a 33 1/3% chance of winning. But us, we got a 66 2/3% chance of winning because Michigan knows they can't beat us, and they're not even gonna try. So Penn State? You talking about Penn State? Well, Penn State, you take your 33 1/3% chance minus our 25% chance, and you got an 8 1/3% chance of winning at Big Dance, motherfucker. I added that in for dramatic effect. Let's go. But then you take your 75% chance of winning. If we were to go one-on-one, and you add that 66 2/3% and we got a 141 2/3% chance of winning it all. See, Adam, the numbers don't lie, and they spell disaster for you at Indy, bud. Fucking count it. Let's get it. All right. Spicy Leather Boy, you never know. And then, with that, that thick hog, without any kind of hesitation, Coach A comes in here and fucking drags it across all their mouths and says, after their conference tourney run, I'm convinced at worst they're a Sweet 16. Fucking book it, baby. That's why he's the coach, because they are the Sweet 16. Second team ever to be a number 15 seed and make it, woo, to that Sweet 16. We gotta go ahead and cheers to the master. Let's get it. Next, WWE releasing news, breaking news, that Charlotte, I have no ass Flair. Charlotte, I look like my dad, drunk Ric Flair. Charlotte, my brother, fucking, what's his nuts Flair, was a better wrestler than me. David Flair, that's the one. All right. She's going to go ahead and be in the remake of the 1973 film, One Drink Everyone Knows the Rule. Be in a remake of the 1973 film, Walking Tall. As you guys know, my boy, Dwayne The Rock Johnson, hey, Rocky baby, go ahead and drop a like in the comments. Let us know you're here. I know you're here, but let the Pat Crackers and Crack Packers know, baby. CPA for life. All right. She's going to be in the remake of Walking Tall. Coach A responds to WWE, again, out of nowhere, unsolicited. This would be the second remake of that film. Well, wrong, motherfucker. This wouldn't be. This is gonna be. It's locked in. She's the star. Count it. That's my thick hog slapping you in the mouth, motherfucker. And then let's take a little closer look right there. And what do we see? We see some dude with a little bright Nike shirt and a panda hat. And what's he say? He says, I want skeins beans on my chin. Well, I bet you do. Huh? And I know just the place to make that happen. So, I'm gonna go ahead and slide on across that bridge, kick down that fucking door, walk on onto that floor, and say, hey, Skeens, this panda boy wants your beans. All right, next story. Dig it. Coach A. Well, my bracket's busted on day one. Fucking hell. He must have had the Buckeyes going all the way to run on the table like that spicy leather boy. You guys shouldn't spend too much time together, you know what I mean? All right. But then, because no one else is giving him any love, Coach A responds to himself. I've never seen a team like this Ohio State team in years, aka this squad. When on, they can beat literally anyone. But when they're not, they can lose to the worst teams on the planet. Well, isn't that fucking saying a lot there, Coach A? When they're good, they win. When they're bad, they lose. Fuck me, that's the game, all right, pal? You're telling me something I don't already know? That my Pat Crackers don't already know? That CPA doesn't already know? This is stuff we should be telling you. This is day one shit. Level one shit. You're good, you win, you lose, you lose. Nothing needs to be said. But for some reason, you decide to say it. All right. And then, because no one replies to that, what do we see? Pulling hard for Illinois and Iowa now. Not so fast, my friend. Fuck me, they both lost too. Jesus Christ. Remember, trademark. You heard it from me first, not that nutso Corso. All right, next story. And this is a sad one. All you Cleveland Brown fans, Doug, sorry, pal. UA Hunter, up Arlington Hunter, Skull Session, Justin Ryan, all you little brownies out there. Man, a lot of you Pat Crackers are brownies. So, all you, the whole Doug clan, all right, your former boy, Kellen Winslow Jr., is disgusting and needs to be locked up. His ass got 14 years in Snake Eyes, 2314's opinion, not enough for what he did. But he got 14 years. I want you to focus in on what Coach A had to say. So much talent wasted. Could tell this, could tell his last year at Miami, he was a bit of a head fake. Oh, one take, everyone knows the rules. What was that? Looks like someone dropped a... I don't know what that was, full disclosure. All right, let's go ahead and reset. Redo, one drink. Say it with me, everyone knows the rule. All right, so much talent wasted. Could tell his last year at Miami, he was a bit of a head case. Turns out, more than a bit. So, let's do the math here. Coach A, as we all know, Coach A is 32. Because we just sang him happy birthday a few weeks ago. It was his birthday. 32. Kellen Winslow was in Miami, the Hurricanes. His last year, I looked it up, was 2001-2002. So that's right. Coach A was only fucking 14 years old. And at 14, you're telling me this motherfucker could spot that this guy was a head case? He knew what was going to happen? Well, pal, why didn't you fucking warn anybody? You know what I mean? Come on. That we're going to go ahead and close it out there. Once again, Coach A proving that he has the gift. He has the sight. He can fucking call the shots, pull the plays. Thick hogs flying. Beans are rising. All right. As always, Pack Crackers, Crack Packers. Two things for you to do, baby. I got two for you. Pack those cracks, crack those packs. Let's fucking go. CPA for life. Hit the music, cue the lights.